हेलो एवरीवन, गुड मॉर्निंग, वेलकम टू द क्लास। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट लेसन नंबर 3 इन एसएस। सो एवरीवन, नाउ ओपन योर बुक्स टू पेज नंबर 19। व्हाट इज द टाइटल? मोमेंट्स ऑफ द अर्थ। Now, what do you mean by movement of earth? We all know that earth revolves around sun and rotates on its own axis. These are the movements of the earth. So, let's study what is revolution, rotation and even other movements of the earth that cause day and night. Due to what factors the seasons change? Okay, so let's get started. First, you can see in your book what the sun is saying. Hi, I am the sun. With me, here are the 4 inner planets. Now, what do you mean by inner planet? The planets near to sun are known as inner planet. Mercury, Venus, Earth and Mars. They along with the other outer planet, Jupiter, Saturn, Uranus and Neptune, go around me. This moment is called revolution. Okay, so now what is revolution? You can see the sun. When the planets move around the sun, round and round, this moment is called revolution. Now, I am Mars. We are also called the terrestrial planet. I am Earth, I am Venus, I am Mercury. Now in the next image, you can see I am circling round the sun. But do you know that I am going round and round on my own too? So I am both revolving and rotating. So first is revolution. What is revolution? When the planets go around the sun, round, this is known as revolution. And what is rotation? Earth, you have seen a top means lattu. It rotates the same way. Earth also rotates on its own axis. So this is known as rotation. Next, movements of the earth. We see varying position of the sun at different times of the day. For example, at noon, the sun is right over your head and you feel its heat and brightness. In the evening, the sun sets in the west. The position of the sun gives us the impression that the sun keeps moving from one corner of the sky to the other. However, the fact is that the sun never moves. The planets in the solar system, including the Earth, are the ones that are always in motion. The Earth has 2 basic movements. The movements are rotation and revolution. Now here, example is given, right? In the morning, you will see sun rising from one side. At the noon, the sun will be right above your head. And in the evening, the sun sets in the west, means the sun rises in the east and sets in the west. By seeing this, some of us may think that sun regularly keeps moving. It comes from the east, then on the top, then goes to the west. But no, it is our earth that is always in motion, and due to which we experience different climates, day and night, and different position of sun. Now, what is Rotation. When you spin a top, it rotates on its axis. Top means लट्टू. When you spin it, वो गोल गोल घूमता है ना एक ही जगह पे. The same way, earth also rotates on its axis. The earth takes 24 hours to complete one rotation. How many hours? 24 hours to complete one rotation. The only difference is that the axis of the earth is invisible because it is an imaginary line. The earth rotates in a slightly slanted position as its axis is tilted. Now what happens? The axis of earth is invisible. The direction of the rotation is from west to east. Now what is the direction of rotation of the earth? From west to the east. That's why we see sun rising in the west, east and setting in the west. That is why it appears as though the sun rises in the east and sets in the west. Now day and night. Day and night are caused by the earth's rotation. How they are caused? By earth's rotation. As the earth rotates, a part of the planet faces the sun. Now you can see the image. Once the earth has rotated, half earth is in sunlight and half earth is in dark. So the half part which is in sunlight experiences day, whereas the half part that is far away from the sight of sun experiences night. The next is revolution. While rotating on its axis, the earth moves around the sun in a fixed path. Now you can see sun and the earth is moving round and round around the sun. The fixed path is called orbit and the earth's orbit is elliptical. Now underline this. The fixed path is called an orbit and the earth's orbit is elliptical. This movement of the earth around the sun is called revolution. Now what is elliptical? Oval in shape. It is not circular. It is oval like an egg. The earth takes 1 year or 365 and quarter days to complete one revolution. How many days? Underline 365 and 1/4 days. However, we consider one calendar year to have 365 days. That is why we have 365 days in 1 year. So, according to what we take time, the earth rotates once in 24 hours. So, we consider it as one day and it completes its revolution around the sun in 365 and 1/4 days. So, we consider 365 days as 1 year, and the balance of 1/4 day or 6 hour is added up for 4 years. Now do you know, some after 4 years we have 29 days in February. Why so? Because we take all the 1/4 days of every year, we calculate them, that is approximately 6 hours. So 6 plus 6 plus 6 plus 6, 6 fours are 24. So it becomes one day. So we add up that one day after each 4 year in the month of February. That's why we have leap year. It is also known as leap year. We have 366 days in a leap year. How many days? 366 days in a leap year. Therefore, any year divisible by 4 is a leap year. So in today's lecture, what we studied is rotation, revolution, causes of day and night, and about leap year. So, this is enough for today. The rest of the portion we will complete in next session. Okay, and if you are having any doubt in this portion, you can ask me. Bye everyone.